Hey, you guys. Okay, I'm going to go over how to do an event for your person really quick. So you as the sponsor, this is your guide, okay? So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to talk to them about a day and a time. I personally love Thursday nights and Sunday nights for these, but plan them accordingly. If you're, if the discount runs out on an XYZ day, make sure you do these before that, okay? Urgency is really important. Also, I don't like to do it the last day of the month because I like to have at least 2 or 3 days to do some follow-ups. Okay, the second thing you're going to do after you have your day and time is you're going to make sure that your person, your prospect, let's call her Sarah, you're going to make sure Sarah knows what this is for. This is not one of those things where I'm going to like try and hide all the mess that's happening back here. Okay, and here, oh my gosh, don't look anywhere. But what you're going to do is you're going to make sure they know the intentions. So the intention behind an event is not to have a million people come to you and say, okay, let's go, let's sign up. It's for you to create a follow-up list to start the conversation and to educate a lot of people at one time. Okay, that's the point. It is not to have 5, 10, 20 people come to them afterwards and say, sign me up. Not going to happen. Okay, so now after they have the right, they know you've set the intentions, they know the point of this, then it's your turn to go in and make the group. So you're going to go to Facebook groups, click the little plus sign, create a group. Then you're going to add a cover photo. If you go into our team page and type in first event or event, there's a post that has like health and happiness, has a little graphic. You can actually save that graphic and use it, or you can make your own on Word Swag or Pic Collage. Those are my favorite groups, or my favorite apps. But either way, add a cover photo. You're going to name it. I usually do like their name, health and happiness event, or wellness event, or health and happy hour. And then I'll put like the little squiggly line and put the day that it's going to happen, like 12/9 or whatever it is. Okay. By the way, we just did bunk beds. So this is my daughter's bed that we took out. It's not like junk. Okay. Anyway, so after you've created the group, it's going to ask you to add someone. I always just add Sarah. I add Sarah to it and then say, message her and be like, hey, I just made your group, just added, go accept it so I can make you an admin. Done. Simple. Then I'm going to send her a screenshot of how to add a description in. Y'all, if you do this whole thing for them, then they have no skin in the game. But if you give them some homework, it gives you a good idea of how invested they actually are in this whole thing, and that is important. You are hand-holding, but you are also guiding at the same time. So I hand-hold and give homework. I send them a screenshot of how to add in a description on the group. You can figure it out, you guys. I usually click the little shield at the top right-hand corner, and then it takes me to, I think, group settings, and then it lets me add a description. Once you've made them an admin, they can go in and do that. And then I send her a screenshot, send Sarah, of one that I've done before and say, write something like this in there with your day and time. And so that she does that, something really simple. Hey, I'm so glad you're here. I'm so thankful that you're here to support me and to learn more about gut health. Day, time. See you then. Simple, okay? So she's added the description in. Then as her sponsor, as Sarah's sponsor, are going to send her screenshots. There's Kennedy in her bathing suit when it's 5 degrees outside. Send her screenshots or copy and pasteable message ideas for her to go send out. Okay. I say, hey, listen, here's an example for a potential that you've never talked to before. Here's an example for your mom. I might even like sit down with her and get on the phone and be like, hey, let's talk about 3 people really quick you want to invite, and let's figure out some verbiage. Okay. So give them some verbiage examples, you guys. Knowing what to say and who to invite, what and who, those are the 2 main things you need to help them with. Okay. So
I'm a unicorn.
That's awesome. This is a great video. I know. Okay. So once you've done that, then you are going to And they started inviting people. Then you're going to create the content for it. And so I've done so many events before, but I can guide you on exactly what types of things I put in there. But just know this. I schedule them 5 minutes apart. I do a welcome post. I do like a why do you need supplements post. I do a post about gut health. I do a post about what the triplex is. I hit on a few different products based on the people that are coming, okay? And then I will add in testimonies based on who is coming. So posts every 5 minutes for an hour, maybe an hour and 10, maybe an hour and 15 minutes, depending on how it's going. I always have some sort of a giveaway in there, a participation post. The post about, there's a post that does like, what numbers can you relate to? And it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you know. One is I'm bloated. One is my doctor told me I need to lose weight. I have food sensitivities. I need more energy. I'm tired all the time. I live on naps. So then they get to comment what numbers they struggle with. Y'all, that is the best follow-up tool right there. So once you, and I'll explain why in a second. So once you've scheduled all the posts, there's a when you go in to make a post, you guys, at the top, it like actually says schedule with a little drop down. You get to pick the time. So you go schedule them. Then you have your person like the day before, right? Have them go to everyone they invited that said yes and send them the link again to the event and say, hey, I just want to make sure you have this because the fun starts tomorrow. I can't wait. And then set a reminder in that message so that at 5 minutes before the first post happens, it says, my wellness event, can't wait, or whatever. It pops up on their messenger. It's like a reminder for them to go check that group.
You don't say pops up?
That's not a bad word. And then they have the group right there, okay? So they've already messaged them, they said yes, and then they've sent them a link, and they've set a reminder, okay? Right there, we already have three touches, right? Then you're going to encourage them to tag their people during the event on posts that they need to be commenting on or that they need to be seeing. Like, you know so-and-so struggles with anxiety. Make sure they go see it. Go tag them in that and then message them and say, hey, I just tagged you in a message in a post. Did you see it? Okay, so it's these constant touches back and forth. It's this follow-up. By the end of this event, they should have messaged them probably 3 times. You know, they've got the initial, they sent the link, they've set the reminder, they've tagged them in a post and said, hey, it's starting. I just tagged you in a post. Did you see it? And then after the event, the follow-up starts. I love, if my schedule allows for it, I love to get on a Zoom right after their event for 30 minutes, an hour at the most, if they've got a lot of conversations going, and just help them follow up. Sending messages like, hey, I tagged you in a few posts. I'm so glad you came. It means the world to me. Tell me what questions you have after that event. I know there was so much information. Or something really simple like, hey, did you relate to anything I
put? Brother Cannon.
We'll talk about Brother Cannon in a little bit. Could you relate to anything that was on that group? I know there's so much that gut health is connected to, and I didn't even know about it all before I started. And now I do, and it's just, I'm in shock. So helping them send those follow-up messages and then helping them get you in three-way messages. And that's where the Zoom comes in because you actually get to do that with them, okay? So hold their hand. Let them know that they're not alone. Let them know that they don't have to know everything. They just have to get you in three-way messages. Be willing to spend the time with them after. Set the intentions. It's all about follow-up. And then as people sign up, you announce it in that group. Hang on, baby, okay?
Okay.
You announce it in that group and say, hey, so-and-so just got their discount, just got their welcome pack. This is the one she chose. I'm so excited for her. And so it's like creates this momentum in that group. So I hope that helps. If not, let me know. Hey, message me if you have questions.